वेलकम टू वीलर्न, वीलर्न में आपका स्वागत है। वी आर कवरिंग मैनेजमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक एंटरप्राइजेस सेशन 20 एंड 21, डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट एक्सपीरियंस एंड स्ट्रेटजीज एंड इम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट्स। टॉपिक कवर्ड आर व्हाट टू डिसइन्वेस्ट, sequencing of disinvestment, how to disinvest, strategic issues arising out of disinvestment, voluntary retirement scheme, retention agreement, retraining, employee shareholding scheme. When we talk what to disinvest, तो जब डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट की बात आती है, इट इज बेसिकली एंड प्रेफरेबली ऑफ अ पब्लिक एंटरप्राइज टू प्राइवेटाइज, और ये तब होता है जहां पे कंपैरेटिव एडवांटेजेस के होते हैं एंड वेयर एवर इट लूजेज इट्स कंपैरेटिव एडवांटेज एज अ पब्लिक एंटरप्राइज। तो एज लॉन्ग एज अ पब्लिक एंटरप्राइज रादर देन प्राइवेट एंटरप्राइज इज फाउंड to be a superior means of contributing to national well-being, and so long it does not suffer from a comparative disadvantage, it is preferred to have other social reforms rather than privatization or disinvestment. जो comparative advantage होता है, it is measured in terms of commercial returns, या फिर social return क्या है, या what is the desired trade-off between them? इट इज वेरी मच एसेंशियल कि हम ट्राइफर्केट करें पब्लिक सेक्टर एंटरप्राइजेस को, जैसे कि दोज विच विल बी अलाउड टू डाई। दूसरा हम उसको वेन वी ट्राइफिकेट, तो दूसरा होता है दोज हु वुड बी डाइवेस्टेड, और तीसरा रह जाता है कि दोज टू बी रिटेन्ड इन द पब्लिक सेक्टर। When we say those to be left with the public sector, so there has to be a properly constituted committee who could go about this exercise ek time frame ke andar andar, and that time frame has to be very tight, and then get a list of those enterprises which could clearly be divested. So a virtual automatic selection criteria and category would consist of those enterprises whose presence in the public sector has no economic justification whatsoever. Now there is sequencing of disinvestment. In case of competitive enterprises, जो कि relatively small है, product market के लिए भी और market के लिए भी, they should be sold first among the lot, right? Now this इसके दो purposes हैं और दो advantages हैं which not being able to exploit because they are not being able to exploit the market power, और क्योंकि इसकी वजह से it avoid the difficult post divestiture problems of deregulation, and secondly being amenable to competitive bidding, thereby it avoids the difficulty problem of price setting or negotiation, and which are capable of rapid improvement in performance. Now this strategy is basically followed in Mexico in a very competitive sectors jaise ki the hotels ya auto parts or textile. Here the number of such enterprises, they were large. Their contribution to GDP may be very negligible, and hence their privatization may not have much economic impact. In this view, many governments, they may prefer to divest their large enterprises in first instance only, which may have been the additional advantage of visible impact on the growth rate of the economy. Phir kya hota hai, in eventuality जो टेम्पटेशन वुड बी सेल द बेस्ट रन एंटरप्राइजेस फर्स्ट बिकॉज इट वुड बी इजी टू फाइंड बायर्स फॉर देम. हाउएवर द फाइनेंशियल गेन्स वुड बी स्मॉलर बिकॉज द एंटरप्राइजेस दे आर ऑलरेडी वेल रनिंग. सो द ग्रेटर पोटेंशियल गेन अक्रूज फ्रॉम द सेल ऑफ वर्स्ट रन एंटरप्राइजेस ओनली बिकॉज एंड हियर द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट दे फाइंड प्रॉब्लम इन फाइंडिंग द buyers and not the price, right? Furthermore, when we discuss ki large gains jo hote hain, they are possible in industries jahan pe damage is caused basically by constraint on autonomy and where there is quick decisions where there are required, such as for marketing consumer goods. ठीक है, बट द सेल ऑफ दीज वेल रन एंटरप्राइजेस दे आर हेल्पफुल इन एस्टैब्लिशिंग अ क्रेडिबिलिटी फॉर द प्रोग्राम एंड द डिक्लेयर ऑफ सीरियस इंटेंशंस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. अल्टीमेटली इट इज नॉट मच व्हाट इज डिसइन्वेस्टेड बट हाउ इट इज डिसइन्वेस्टेड दैट मेक्स अ डिफरेंस. एक करेक्ट चॉइस होती है ऑफ एसेट्स विच इनिशियली to be divested and the order in which that should be followed is very crucial for the success of the privatization program. So, jaise ek agar hum Genoa ka example le, there they made the decision to work on all fronts at once, industrial, financial, agricultural and service sector. So there are others who are depending on local circumstances. They have been more selective and choosing those enterprises first who observe the heaviest subsidies or those which are judged to be the most marketable. Another is if the government is keen on getting large additions to revenue. Privatization may start with those which are easy to sell at the highest price. Here it would be the most profitable. So the next in line would be those which are not currently profitable but which could be better managed in the private hands. So this is a very great strategy. When we say how to disinvest, जो डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट का प्रोसेस है बेसिकली इन्वॉल्व्स अ नंबर ऑफ केयरफुली स्ट्रक्चर्ड स्टेप और हर स्टेप को एक बहुत कॉशन के साथ अंडरटेक करना चाहिए. नाउ फेलियर टू ऑब्जर्व ड्यू कॉशंस इट लीड्स टू डिवेलमेंट ऑफ द एंटायर प्रोसेस. नाउ द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज प्रिपरेशन फॉर सेल. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट प्रिपरेशन फॉर सेल उसमें there are number of steps which have to be taken by the government to prepare for the enterprise sale. To pehla jo hai wo hai basically ek legal entity ko create karna for making the sales feasible. Iske liye sari legal transformations are taken care of jaise corporate forms kya hai ya fir permitting private holdings of share kya hai. Then the second step is जो लार्ज और मोनोपोलीज हैं दे आर ब्रोकन इनटू वायबल एंड नॉन वायबल यूनिट्स. फिर अनदर स्टेप इज सेपरेशन ऑफ कॉम्पिटेटिव एक्टिविटीज फ्रॉम नॉन कॉम्पिटेटिव वंस. फिर है कि जो पेरिफेरल एसेट्स हैं उनको आइडेंटिफाइड करना, दोज दैट कुड बी सोल्ड एज अ सेपरेट कंसर्न. देन कम्स अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ न्यू मैनेजर्स जिनका डिफरेंट एटीट्यूड है या अप्रोच है. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट वैल्यूएशन ऑफ एंटरप्राइज इट इज द सेकंड स्टेप. इसमें क्या होता है कि जो बेस्ट मेथड ऑफ वैल्यूएशन होता है पब्लिक एंटरप्राइज का या प्राइजिंग का ऑफ इट्स शेयर्स, इट इज बेसिकली टू लेट द मार्केट डिसाइड थ्रू इट्स कॉम्पिटिटिव बिडिंग. सो हियर इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि जो बिडर्स हैं दे शुड वेरी वेल क्वालिफाई and pre-qualified the regulatory environment which must provide incentives for modernization. Underpricing ki agar hum baat kare तो बहुत बार देखा गया है कि पब्लिक एंटरप्राइज वेयर दे हैव बीन सोल्ड, जो शेयर प्राइस है विच इज यूजुअली अंडर प्राइज्ड. सो एज अ स्ट्रेटजी टू अचीव क्विक सक्सेस एंड एस्टैब्लिश क्रेडिबिलिटी फॉर फ्यूचर सेल्स, तो इन्वेस्टर्स दे मेक प्रॉफिट एंड आर फेवरेबली डिस्पोज्ड टुवर्ड्स द प्राइवेटाइजेशन प्रोग्राम. वेयर शेयर्स हैव बीन ओवरप्राइज्ड, इन्वेस्टर्स दे टेंड टू लूज एंड आर वेरी वैरी ऑफ फ्यूचर पब्लिक ऑफरिंग्स. नाउ देयर इज अ स्कीम ऑफ डिस्काउंट्स. इधर क्या होता है कि गवर्नमेंट जो है पॉलिटिकल सपोर्ट को विन करने के लिए बहुत सारे फिस्कल सैक्रिफाइसेस करती है, एंड दीज फिस्कल सैक्रिफाइसेस दे आर बेसिकली इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑफरिंग डिस्काउंट्स स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर्स को या फिर इंस्टीट्यूशनल इन्वेस्टर्स को. हियर व्हाट हैपेंस, दे पे वेरी हाई प्राइसेस फॉर देयर शेयर्स ईदर थ्रू फिक्स्ड प्राइसेस और बाय द टेंडर ऑफरिंग. फिर आता है फिफ्थ, गोल्डन शेयर. तो ये हियर व्हाट हैपेंस, जो मोडालिटीज होती हैं सेल्स की, जैसे कि यूके में हुआ, इट गिव्स ओवरराइडिंग पावर टू द गवर्नमेंट व्हिच होल्ड्स द गोल्डन शेयर, एंड इट इज बेसिकली डन टू प्रिवेंट ट्रांसफर ऑफ मोर देन 50% ऑफ द वोटिंग स्टॉक और वॉलंटरी वाइंडिंग अप ऑफ द firm and the power to intervene in crucial issues. एक और step होता है sale in tranches. So what happens? Many countries they appear to have resorted to government of financial sales for debt because their financial systems they were not deep enough. जहाँ पर भी state owned enterprises they were not sufficiently attractive and they were not preferred by buyers who do not have enough cash. However, it would do better to sell for cash even at a lower price also than accepting the debt. So cash sales, it provides liquidity to pay liabilities of the enterprise as well as the severances paid to the redundant employer. When we talk about the strategies, issues which are arising out of disinvestment, तो जो पहला issue है वो है transparency का. तो transparency it basically includes studies to inform the public कि reasons क्या है divestiture के, and it helps in creating credibility and dispel doubts regarding the shady deals. So both transparency and the speed, they are served by the centralized policy units or agencies who are responsible for privatization rather than in the cabinet commission or sector ministry. The latter may lack the administrative capacity, like it create delays that have a vested interest in keeping the state firms in their original forms and make process less transparent. दूसरा होता है new investment. तो जो privatization programs होते हैं वो तभी successful होते हैं अपने objective को achieve करने में जब वो new investment को attract कर सकें. And there have been the main stimulus to flow international investment. अगर हम जमैका की अगर बात करें तो the privatization related flows they accounted for 94% of the total inward foreign investment in the year 1987. फिर होता है लेबर रिडंडेंसी. लेबर रिडंडेंसी इट हैपेंस जैसे कंट्रीज विच आर डाइवर्स एज अर्जेंटीना, जापान, मेक्सिको या न्यूजीलैंड, दे हैव टर्मिनेटेड देयर सरप्लस स्टेट एम्प्लॉयज प्रायर टू प्राइवेटाइजेशन. सो एट टाइम्स इट बिकम्स वेरी नेसेसरी कि गवर्नमेंट इट डज सच एन एक्सरसाइज इफ एन एंटरप्राइज इज टू बी सोल्ड, क्योंकि जो इन्वेस्टर्स हैं दे शाय अवे फ्रॉम द सरप्लस लेबर एंड द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ टैकलिंग रिडंडेंसी. मोर ओवर क्या होता है, गवर्नमेंट्स दे आर बेसिकली एंड यूजुअली दे आर बेटर एबल टू able than the private investor to elevate the any kind of adverse social consequences. So the resistance by government and the workers and the union, it is offset by offering fixed worker severance payment or banning strike, and it also reduces the power of labor union through various measures. Now the prospect of political unrest, when we talk about which are arising from unemployment, has led many governments to approach privatization very cautiously. Government, they should be very much prepared to meet the leaders at an early stage in the discussion. What happened? This would go a long way in reducing opposition to privatization process, especially if it is accompanied by a well-planned educational campaign. Another is, there are labor union distrust of privatization. What happens? It becomes a threat to their pension and other labor rights. Here what happens, state-owned enterprises, in most cases, they are basically overmanned. So in many state-owned enterprises, there is a phantom worker, that is worker who do not work but they are paid. And therefore, reduction in labor force might only mean elimination of these kind of worker. So the sale of to a private sector would almost certainly result in the reduction of the workforce. So the amount of reduction in the labor force, it would depend on its composition. It would also, there are countries where there are multiple industrial opportunities exist. So there what happened, the placement of surplus labor, they may not be a problem, though retaining may be required. So in some developing countries where unemployment rates are extremely high and there is a little alternative employment and no societal security system, government, they have to balance the immediate cost involving severance pay. Further, kya hota hai? Privatization is actually an instrument of increasing the workforce over the long term, and it is done through increase of business ya fir diversification of business hota hai. So the overall growth in the economy, it could follow with the higher employment in other sectors as well, such as services that might not otherwise be available. Hum voluntary retirement scheme ki baat karte hain, which is VRS. Most of the private enterprises in the world, you know, they have always been overmanned. So the World Bank, in the study of their five countries, Chile, Egypt, Ghana, India and Turkey, they have concluded that overstaffing has varied between 20 to 90%. So it's a phenomenal range. So the normal method of reducing this overstaffing to desirable level, it has been done through adoption of VRS, voluntary retirement scheme. So ye jo scheme hai, ye monetary compensation provide karta hai un employees ko jo VRS ke liye opt karte hain, or those who retire. Here the amount of compensation, it varies from 30 days pay or for every year of service which are rendered, or the number of years of service which is left. So whichever is less, subject to a maximum. So this compensation, it basically serves as a social safety net for retiring worker. Agar hum India ke case ki baat kare, minimum VRS compensation which has been fixed by law, right? In Sri Lanka, here the compensation is decided on a case to case basis. Kya hua India mein, National Renewal Fund, that is NRF, was established to provide funds for VRS compensation. In India, up to May 1999, 0.13 million CPSC workers, they have opted for VRS under NRF scheme. When we talk about retention agreements, privatization जो होती है, it becomes a very painful process if special measures are not taken care of, so that the negative impact on employment is cushioned. One such measure is for the government to enter into agreement with the purchaser of the enterprise, guaranteeing retention and service of employees for a certain period of time after a change in the ownership. So such an agreement, it helps to smoothen the process of transition from public to private sector. Now by the time ye agreement expire karta hai, it is expected that the government and the environment would improve considerably and that the workers would have less problem in adjusting to downsizing. Is tarah ka arrangement jo hai wo prices ko depress karta hai, which the purchaser is willing to pay for the ownership. Further, when we talk about retraining, developed countries jaise UK mein hai, when labor is displaced due to downsizing in the private enterprises, they are paid unemployment benefits till such time they become employed elsewhere. So it is an incentive which is provided by the government. यहाँ पे जो स्टेट है, जो गवर्नमेंट है, वो बेसिकली दे आर कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द सेफ्टी नेट, और ये एक इंडिविजुअल पे छोड़ देती है कि वेदर ही वांट्स टू एक्वायर ट्रेनिंग और स्किल्स ऑन हिज ओन. एम, जो बेसिक एम होता है इन कंट्रीज का, बेसिकली इज टू मेक द मार्केट ऑपरेट मोर एफिशिएंटली. सो दिस रिलायंस on the market coordinates the demand and supply of skills, which preclude any action from the part of the government in avoiding or limiting worker displacement. Now, by encouraging entry of a large number of players in the market, government jo hai wo ensure karta hai ki there is competition or there is a increased opportunity for displaced worker. फर्दर मोर क्या होता है कि जो स्टेट होता है, इट ऑल्सो अरेंज फॉर एडिक्वेट कॉम्पेंसेशन फॉर वर्कर्स हु आर बीइंग डिस्प्लेस्ड, राइट. जैसे एग्जाम्पल लें कि इंडिया का केस, तो गवर्नमेंट हैज प्रोवाइडेड फॉर कॉम्पेंसेटिंग दोज पीपल हु आर ऑप्टिंग फॉर द वीआरएस, एंड टिल अ फ्यू ईयर्स अगो दे वर अंडरटेकिंग रीट्रेनिंग और एक्विजिशन ऑफ न्यू स्किल्स ऑफ re-employment or self-employment. There are many workers who have frittered away their compensation money in social functions like marriages. So what happens, most privatized enterprises, they have been resorted to downsizing workers where there are no attempt is being made by the government. So the problem there is can be addressed. Pehla hai, through entry of adequate number of competitive players in the areas which are operated by the public enterprise. Aur dusra hai, jo incumbent hai, jo new privatized enterprise hai, by making it finance reframing program. So fortunately, some foreign assistance now is available for such retraining, and it has been ameliorated the situation to some extent. अगर हम employee shareholding scheme की बात करते हैं, तो जो allocation of proper proportion of share privatized employees का है, that is, these includes free shares or discounted share price, they have become a very standard feature in any privatization policy. सेकेंड, अगर हम बिजनेस टेलीकम्युनिकेशन को एग्जाम्पल लें, देर आर 54 फ्री शेयर्स पर एम्प्लॉय, सो दे आर द मेजर्स विच आर अडॉप्टेड, एंड ऑल्सो मैचिंग शेयर्स, दैट इज that is 2-for-1 up to 77 per employee is also taken care of. Furthermore, 10% discount for up to 1600 shares per employee is purchased under priority arrangement. Also, on British Airways, employees received 76 shares, free shares per employee, and the matching shares for 2-for-1 up to 120 per employees and up to 1600 shares of each employee under the priority offer at a discount of 10%. Now there are two exercises. What are the implications of disinvestment on labor, and discuss the ways to tackle such implication. Thank you and have a nice day. Keep learning and we learn.